They'd already put up the decorations at the George Hotel when the announcement was made last week. Tier 3 for Stamford means they must stay closed at the busiest time of year.
You know, this time last year, we had 20,000 people through the hotel in those 5 weeks eating and drinking with us. And we took 1.5 million. This year, if we're shut and we don't get open at all, that's just not there.
The blow feels especially bitter because pre-lockdown, Stamford was in Tier 1. Latest figures put infection rates at 97 per 100,000. Elsewhere in the county, those numbers are in the 400s. But in Boston and East Lindsay, for example, which are 35 and 65 miles away.
Critics point out that residents here don't put pressure on hospitals in Lincolnshire either. They go to nearby Peterborough instead, in Tier 2.
This comes back to people in London drawing lines on the map which don't make sense. And I think all we need is some local discretion to use common sense.
You can feel the indignation on the high street.
It feels a bit like we're in a goldfish bowl. Do you know what I mean? When everyone surrounding us is not in Tier 3 and we are. It doesn't seem fair.
It's inappropriate just to lump us all together. I live in a village just outside in Tier 2. So in theory, I shouldn't come shop in my main town.
Libby Summers can reopen her music shop on Wednesday, but she estimates 3/4 of her trade comes from Tier 2 areas, where the advice is not to travel to Tier 3.
I think it affects many businesses all over the country because the assumption is that, you know, shops trade only comes from their town or location, and that's just not the case for so many businesses.
Stamford's residents believe they and other areas like theirs are being ignored. Pressure is mounting on their Conservative MP not to vote with the government. The Christmas wish list couldn't be clearer. Tessa Chapman, 5 News, Stamford.